It's a question that some people will see for the first time on the ballot this November. Are you for or against your local school district's referendum?
In Danville, voters are being asked to vote on two referendums. As CBS4's Melissa Crash reports, some say they're asking for too much.
As you can see by the signs, voters have a big decision to make come November 5th, and it's causing quite the controversy.
They need to prioritize better.
Dave Potter is talking about the proposed capital and operational referendums by Danville Community Schools, a topic that's dividing the town.
The capital referendum is a $53 million renovation referendum for those buildings. And the operating referendum is 20 cents per $100 of assessed value on a property.
We want it to be well equipped, but we don't like our tax money being wasted like it is.
Superintendent Tracy Schaefer says the capital referendum would transform the inside and outside of the four schools. He says the projects are years overdue, including a focus on school security.
Once they enter our building, they're able to have a lot of freedom throughout the building. That we'd like to contain that and make that a safer situation for our students.
The operational referendum would help retain teachers and maintain transportation.
We've turned over 65 teachers out of a staff of 146 in the last 4 years. Many of whom have left to take higher salaries in other districts that can pay more dollars.
Danville isn't the only district with a referendum on the ballot. Several others are asking the public to raise taxes this year. Hardy Murphy is a clinical professor at IUPUI.
They have to make sure that the message is right. People have to resonate with it.
The Center for Evaluation and Education Policy at IU created a referendum database. It looks into what works and what doesn't.
You're going to have to get to know what the climate is in your community.
Like when it comes to how much of a tax increase districts are proposing.
About 30 cents per $100 of valuation seems to be moving into the sweet spot. When you get above that, sometimes the voters tend to reject it, but that's not always true.
And what time of the year the referendum is up for vote?
Elections in May are more successful than elections in November.
While residents like Potter hope that stands true,
regardless of the outcome, we need to come together afterwards.
It'll be up to the voters to determine the future of Danville schools.
In schools, you're either improving or you tend to be getting worse, and we need to be able to compete.
For a complete list of all the referendums up for vote this November in the state of Indiana, head on over to our website. For now, reporting in Danville, I'm Melissa Crash, CBS 4 News.
The Indiana Bureau of